Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is part two of basic percent problems, and we're just going to do a few more examples on this video, all of them having fractions in them. We're just going to practice doing a few more examples with basic percent problems of this type. Either find a percent of a number, or it might say, what is a certain percent of a number? So we'll know the percent of some number. All right, so let's do this problem. Find 33% of 57. So remember, what we have to do is we have to rewrite 33 and a percent as a fraction or a decimal. And we're only going to use the decimal if we could write it as an exact decimal. And then of, remember that means you're going to multiply. And then we've got our other number, 57. So in this case, 33 and 1/3%, we can't write that as an exact decimal because 1/3 is 0.33333 repeating forever. So let's write 33 and a third percent as a fraction. And I'm sure some of you already know what that is, but here's the steps. 33 and a third percent means 33 and a third. Percent means per 100 out of 100, so we divide by 100. That was 33 and a third. So how do you do a mixed number divided by 100? You first want to change that mixed number to an improper fraction. 33 times 3 plus 1 will be 100 for the numerator, and it's still over 3. And then when you divide by 100, remember you multiply by the reciprocal 1/100. This is a very common percent, 33 and a third percent, so you might want to just remember 33 and 1/3 percent is the same thing as the fraction 1/3. So what do I have here? I've got 1/3 times, for the of, 57. And I'm going to go ahead and write that as 57 over 1. Now you could multiply 57 over 3 and use your calculator, and in this case it does come out to a whole number. But if it doesn't, then you would just be doing some reducing here. And I'm going to do it by reducing. 3 goes into 57 19 times. So my answer is 19 over 1, or 19. So does that make sense? That 19 is about a third of 57? Well, a third of 60, hopefully you realize, is going to be 20. So this seems like a reasonable answer. All right, here's another one. See if you can try this on your own by putting the video on pause first, doing it, and then checking back in with me. All right, this is similar. What is 60% of 9 and 1/4? So we know what the percent is, and we know what the number is. Now, we can write both of these as decimals and multiply, or we could write both of these as fractions and multiply. Either way will work. Let's write it as fractions first. So I'm going to have to write 60% as a fraction. And if you want, you could simply write 60 over 100, or you could reduce that and write 3/5. I'm just going to write 60 over 100. And 9 and 1/4, well, because I've got of means times, 9 and 1/4. To multiply by fractions, you want to write that as an improper fraction. So that'll be 4 times 9 plus 1. The numerator will be 37 over 4. So this is if I don't reduce this first. Right, and now what we could do is try reducing and see where we go from here. Let's see. I can do the 4 into the 60, or I could reduce the 60 over 100. It really doesn't matter. I'm going to do the 4 into the 60. I'm going to give you 15 right here. And then 15 over 100, is there a number that goes into both of those? There is, but, and so we could do that, and we'll get our answer in terms of a fraction. So if we do that, let's see, 5 goes into both of those, 3 and 20, and then there's nothing else that reduces, right? So what do I end up with if I were going to write this answer as a fraction? I would have 3 times 37, which is 111, over 20. So that's correct. And of course, you could write this as a mixed number if you'd like. It's okay to write it either way. 5 and 11/20. Now, let's do it again. Let's say I change everything to decimals instead. 60%, we could write that as 0.6, because remember, percent means divide by 100, you move the decimal to the left. So I have 0.6 times, I'm going to use parentheses, 9 1/4. Now, since I'm writing the percent as a decimal, I'm going to go ahead and write the 9 1/4 as a decimal, and hopefully you know 1/4 is the same thing as 0.25. If not, you might want to go back and practice how to change a fraction to a decimal. So this gives me 9.25. So now I've got it in terms of decimals, and you could either multiply out those two numbers the long way, or you can get out your calculator and do 0.6 times 9.25, which is 5.55. So notice it looks different than when I wrote it as of 111/20 or 5 11/20. This 5 11/20 is the fraction form, and 5.55 is the decimal form. And you could convince yourself of that if you want by writing 5.55 as, that's the same thing as 5 55/100. And if you reduce that 55/100, you do get 5 11/20. So they're exactly the same thing. It's just one's written in decimal form and one's written in fraction form. So if somebody asks you, what is 60% of 9 1/4? Any of these three answers are fine, unless it's specified to give your answer in a specific form. Looking back up to this first way I did it, remember, you could have changed 60/100 to 3/5 first. And if you would have done that, then of course you would have 3/5 times 37/4, and you would have gotten directly to 111/20. So if you reduce it first, there's nothing that needed to be canceled before I got that 111/20. So the idea is you're multiplying, whether you reduce at the beginning of the problem or at the end of the problem. In the end, there's one answer that's most reduced, and any of these three are okay answers for this. Here's another one for you to try on your own first. So put the video on pause and then come back. All right, this time we have 8 1/3% of 36. So we can't change 1/3 to a decimal without having a repeat. So we're going to have to write 8 1/3% as a fraction. Let's figure that out first. Oops, don't know what all that funny stuff is. So 8 1/3%. What does that equal? Well, first I want to write 8 1/3 as an improper fraction, 25/3. And then percent means divide by 100 or multiply by 1/100. All right. So if I reduce that, 8 1/3 is really just 1/12. So now I come back here. I want to write 8 1/3 as 1/12 times 36. And I'm going to write that as 36/1. And then 12 goes into 36 three times. So if you reduce that, we get our answer of 3. So 8 1/3% of 36 is the number 3. Now, you can estimate this again. 8 1/3% is less than 10%, and 10% would be 3.6. So this seems like a reasonable answer. It's a little bit less than 3.6. All right, here's another one. So again, see if you can figure this out on your own first. So what do we have here? We've got 8 1/7% of 350. Now, you could go and figure out what 8 1/7% is first and then write it here, or watch what I'm going to do, which is slightly different, just to mix things up a bit. 8 1/7 I can write as, well, an improper fraction, 7 times 8, which is 56 plus 1, so that's 57 over 7, right? And then my percent sign, that means divide by 100 or times by 1/100. So what I could do is just write this all at once. This is the same thing, 57 over 7 times 1/100. That's rewriting 8 1/7%. And the reason I'm doing this is because nothing's going to cancel anyway. Now I've got the of means times, and then I've got 350. So I'm going to write that as 350 over 1. Now I want to see if we could reduce anything. Well, the 7 goes into 35, right? 5 times. So 7 into 350 will go 50 times, right? You have that extra 0. And then is there anything else I could cancel? Well, 100 and the 50. I could divide each of those by 50. So that's going to be a 1 up there and a 2 here. And now there's nothing else that cancels. So in the numerator, I've got 57 times 1 times 1, which is 57. And in the bottom, all I have is a 2. So 57 sevenths is the answer, or if you want to write that as a mixed number, that would be 2 into 57, so what is that? That's 28 and a half. Or you could write this as 28.5 if you're going to write 1/2 in decimal form. Now, of course, if you want to do all this with your calculator, in this case, it actually would have worked out because it wouldn't come up with a repeating decimal. The original numbers you had in the numerator were 57, 1, and 350. And in the denominator, 7 times 100 times 1. So if you did this multiplication in the numerator and divided by 700, you would get 28.5 coming up on your calculator. So you've seen several problems of this type where we know the percent and we're trying to find a percent of a given number. So when we know the percent and what the number is, all we do is change the percent to a fraction or a decimal and then multiply by the number. There are different kinds of percent problems which we'll do in the next video. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com where you can view all of my videos which are organized by topic.